performing enteroshrift bacteria. Isolated organism were showing fluorescence, blue fluorescence pigment. Pigment indicates characteristic. Pseudomonas fluorescence identify blue fluorescence pigment dikhata hai. As a result of 6-mass RNA analysis and biochemical test, Pseudomonas protozoan were isolated. It is reference. Thank you.
The next presenter is OP14.
Good afternoon, all of you. My name is Bhagavala Mohammed Suday, L5 BSc Biotech, Pramukh Swami, SD Patel Arts College. My topic is municipal waste cannot into biofuel. Yeah, my topic, and regarding this topic, I will explain. For this topic, there is a current news. In 2013, newspaper recovered was about 67% and 5.4 million tons, and about 60% of yard trimming were recovered. You know, this table and this food is 14.6 wasted, and paper 27% and glass 4.4%, and metal 9.1%, and plastic 12.8%, and other leather and 9%. Plastic comprises about 13%, wood follows to around 6%, and glass at 5%. What is MSW? Municipal solid waste. Municipal solid waste are commonly known as trash or garbage, construction and demolition debris, condition residue, and from street. This garbage is generated by mainly from a residential commercial complex with rising urbanization and change in lifestyle and food. Nowadays, people use junk foods and etc. So, there is a best example and throwing the garbage here and there. There is also municipal solid waste. So be careful to not use junk food and not throw waste from here and there. So we have to conclude. So we have to comprise this municipal solid waste in this topic. Waste. What does it mean? Water, air, soil, triggers, and economy. We are spoiling the environment. Really, we are spoiling the environment. It is really, there is air pollution, soil pollution, and smoke. Industry are smoke pollution, air pollution, carbon dioxide gas, greenhouse effect, and so many etc. things. They are all about the municipal solid waste, and other is liquid waste. But my topic is only municipal solid waste.
Why should approach to sustainability through technological excellence? Solid waste management. Due to population growth and urbanization, enormous quantities of solid waste are generated. Per day, 7.6 million tons of municipal solid waste is produced or in open dumps. The U.S. Environmental Protection Agency states the Integrated Solid Waste Agency composed of waste source reduction, recycling, waste combustion, and landfills. The primary goal of solid waste management is reducing and eliminating adverse impact of waste material on human health and environment to support the economic development and superior quality of life. We throw
a waste outside, but we cannot reuse and recycle and reduce the waste. It is very problematic issue nowadays. Now, the growth of solid waste in India. In 1981 to 1991, population of Mumbai increased 8.2 million to 12.3 million. So this figure, it is now a very big figure. In 1981 to 1991, to 8.2 million to 12.3 million. It's a very round figure and very big figure. So this municipal solid wastage. During same period, municipal solid waste has grown from 32 tons to 55 tons and increased 67%. Waste collection is very low for all Indian cities. City like Bangalore produces 2,000 tons of waste paper annum. Per annum, the ever increasing waste has put pressure on hygienic condition on the city. Now, plastic waste. This topic is over 5,000 billion pounds of new plastic in manufacture each year, and roughly 33% of that is single use and thrown away. We know that we use totally plastic things nowadays. So we cannot use plastic things. Instead of plastic, we use paper bags and any jute bag, etc. for taking a new for taking a things and go for market. We use the jute bag and cotton cloth bag. We use this type of things without instead of plastic, because plastic is very harmful for our environment, and it is not degradable, and it is degradable because 500 years ago it cannot degradable. So about we cannot use plastic. We can use jute bag, cloth bag, etc., etc. The United Nations estimates plastic account for 4/5 of the accumulated garbage in the world ocean. So this point is very harmful for our environment, and we are all around us. How do plastic waste turn into fuel? The technology of plastic are shredded then heated in a free oxygen chamber known as pyrolysis to about 400 degrees Celsius. As the plastic boils, gas is separated to and often refuse to fuel to machine itself. This is a machine. It is a vacuum. There is a free oxygen. Without free oxygen, this plastic can crush, and the chemical and biofuel can come out. This. Now paper waste. We know that we are throwing the paper outside. If we can use that, we can now this. We are writing on the paper and just throwing the dustbin. It is very harmful for our environment. You see this picture of a paper waste. So many paper waste are thrown away. Just seeing the paper and throwing the garbage. Just seeing the paper and throwing the garbage. It is very harmful, and we use recycle and reduce the paper also. Paper pollution is another effect of paper waste and is a serious problem. It is estimated that 2020. Paper mills will produce 510 tons of paper and paper board each year. Paper accounts for 25% of landfill waste and 33% of municipal waste. Now, food and kitchen waste is a very harmful. It is a very dangerous for this environment. It is a food and kitchen waste. You see the photograph of food and kitchen waste. We cannot. Nowadays people eat the food and buy the apple and throwing the garbage. Now this apple एक थाली में जगह जिसे खाने का रखते हैं खाने खा लेते हैं थोड़ा थोड़ा खाना खाकर अमीर लोग फेंक देते हैं इससे अच्छा गरीब लोगों दे देते तो गरीब लोगों की जिंदगी बन जाती है. While finding way to prevent the food waste is incredibly important, having a way to keep the food from being waste is and also very valuable. Now greenhouse gas, also this part, food and kitchen waste into turn into fuel. Typically talk of food and kitchen waste into energy source involves anaerobic digestion. So what is anaerobic digestion? Anaerobic digestion is simply break down the organic matter into biogas and the biogas leaving organic residue called the digested. ADDIE is the uses the path of the process to treat degradable waste and sewage sludge. This it is widely used as a source of renewable energy. The state of ADDIE process. Anaerobic digestion, you see the hydrolysis, acetogenesis, acetogenesis and methanogenesis. Next conclusion. Safe and effective management of waste is not only a legal necessity but also social responsibility. Paper collection and segregation of biomedical waste. Try to reduce the waste generation. Individual awareness of participator. Use recycled product and communicate about workplace hazard. Thank you very much.
I invite OP15 for the presentation.
Good noon everyone, myself Jhana, and today I am going to present about use of fruit waste to produce a value added product by fungi. Using waste as a substrate for the production of value added product is one of the solution and the remedy for the waste management, and it can also help to solve the different environment issue like the soil solid waste management. The huge quantity of the fruit waste is discarded from many fruit juice bar as well as fruit juice formed industry, and this disposable of fruit waste is cause the health hazardous into living organisms. This fruit waste can easily convert into different value added product like the single cell protein as well as different kind of organic acids. Here the present work is for the undertaken explore the use of the fruit waste in the combinations as a substrate for the production of different value added product. Mainly the fruit waste contain the cellulosic material, and the different microorganisms are there which can convert the cellulose into different kind of sugar, and from that sugar it can easily convert into different value added product. Among the bacteria, Bacillus subtilis, Clostridium species are there. From the fungi, Aspergillus niger, Trichoderma, these are some species which are cellulose degrading microorganisms. The present study shows the production of value added product, which is the organic acid, by using the Aspergillus niger, and it is further concerned for the formation of single cell protein. This is the aim and objective for the present study, to isolate the fruit waste degrading microorganism, to check the hydrolysis of fruit waste into soluble sugar by isolate, to determine the cellulase enzyme activity, to study the organic acid production from the fruit waste by cellulose degrading isolates, and the quantitative and the qualitative determination of organic acid by the chromatographic technique. The methodology, first of all the isolation. So the isolation was mainly done from the soils. The soils were collected from three different regions, that is the paper industry, farm as well as vegetable waste dumping sites. The screening was done with a 60 ml liquid medium which contained a 5% of paper pulp, and the isolation of cellulose degrading microorganism was done with the on a CMC agar media. There was 25 different isolate were obtained, and from that the 23 which we have used for a study into primary screening. The primary screening was done by the Gram-Syodine method on the CMC agar media. The highest zone and the identification of isolates were done by the measuring the zone size. The zone was zone of hydrolysis. The highest zone was measured from ZB21 and 22, which was 20 mm, and the lowest was 14. So from different isolate we have selected 22 for the further bio conversion. The substrate which we have used from the three different substrate we have used, from which there is a two which is orange pills and sugarcane waste, and the another one is a cellulosic waste which is a bit straw. The basal medium was prepared with the 5% of substrate, and the pH was maintained of about 5.8. After sterilization by autoclave, the flasks were inoculated with the 8 disc of growth of Aspergillus niger from the PDA plate. The temperature was maintained about 28 to 30 degrees Celsius. With the interval of every 2 days, the sugar concentration